My dear students, so in the last video we discussed about the what is meant by pump, classification of the pump. Now, and we discussed centrifugal pump construction and working. Today we are going to discuss what is meant by cavitation and priming in pumps. Now, before going to discuss what is meant by cavitation, first you should know what is meant by vapor pressure. Now just consider this diagram. This is a container and the water is stored in the container. Now consider the water first at 20 degree Celsius and the pressure is atmospheric. Now first pressure we assume it is P1. Now here the heat is given to the water. So we assume the boiling point of the water is 100 degree Celsius. Now when we heat this water after a certain period or when the water reaches 100 degree Celsius temperature, what will happen? This water will start converting into vapors. You see here, these are the vapor particles or vapor molecules. These are the water molecules. Now see what is meant by vapor pressure. See, these are the vapors. So these vapors, they exert the pressure on the surface of the water. You see here, this is the water vapor and these are the vapor molecules or particles. So they exert the pressure on the surface of the water. So this is known as vapor pressure. Now we consider the application of the vapor pressure. Okay, now we consider the second diagram. Same water is stored in the container. Okay, now you consider initial pressure is P1 and here we are going to reduce the pressure. Now suppose the pressure is initially less or more, we can consider. Now you just consider here the boiling point of the water is 100 degrees Celsius. There is one constant. As the pressure is more, boiling point is also more. When we reduce the pressure, automatically boiling point will also going to reduce. Now, here the boiling point is 100 degrees Celsius. Pressure is more, that is P1. Now, here what we are going to do, we are going to reduce this pressure. This P2, you consider pressure P2 and P2 is less than P1. So what will happen? Here pressure is more, boiling point is more. Here we are going to reduce the pressure. So what will happen? Automatically boiling point will also going to reduce. Now here we are going to reduce the pressure in such a way that the boiling point of the water will be less than the 20 degrees Celsius. Are you getting? हम यहाँ क्या करने वाले हैं? यहाँ जो प्रेशर P1 था, बॉइलिंग पॉइंट था 100 डिग्री सेल्सियस, यहाँ हम क्या करने वाले हैं? ये प्रेशर जो है P1, वो कम करते 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 जाने वाले हैं। कैसा कम करने वाले हैं? वो उतना कम करने वाले हैं कि यहाँ जो बॉइलिंग पॉइंट था 100 डिग्री, वो अभी कितना हो गया? 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस से कम हो गया। सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट व्हाट विल हैपन, सो विदाउट द हीट दिस वाटर स्टार्ट्स बॉइलिंग. What will happen? Without the heat, the water starts boiling and that water will start converting into vapor molecules. Now, we have to discuss what is cavitation in pump. Already I told you in the last video about the centrifugal pump. You see, this is the centrifugal pump. This is the suction pipe. This is the delivery pipe. Now, what happens? As the water starts converting into vapor molecules, see here, these are the vapor molecules. And we consider this is the low pressure zone. So what will happen? These vapors or vapor particles, they start moving from low pressure zone to high pressure zone. You know that this is the suction, this is the low pressure zone and this is the high pressure zone, delivery pipe. Now what happens? These vapor particles, they move in the form of waves, shock waves or impact waves. And these waves, when they travel, they strike the blades of the impeller. and because of that what will happen, the impeller blades after a certain period may get damaged. So this concept is very important, that is cavitation, formation of the vapor bubbles, and they move, they strike the blades of the impeller, and because of that the impeller after a certain period will be damaged. So this is the cavitation. Is it clear? Thank you.